a curl now. Oh, I have not had nylons in months.
I understand there's a war on.
General von Platzen, Colonel Klink reporting, sir.
Klink, yes, things look very good here. Yeah. Very, very good indeed.
Thank you, Herr General. May I present Colonel Hogan, senior officer of the prisoners of war?
What? Who? Oh, yeah.
As long as you're inspecting, sir, I'd like to complain about the food here.
You are confused, Hogan. I am his inspector general, not yours.
Yeah. Well, it's Hogan, sir. Under international law, I can stay right here and make a list.
If the prisoners do not complain about the food, then I know there is something wrong. You have passed your first test, Klink. Shall we go outside?
By all means, Herr General.
I will inspect your personal staff later. Let us see what we have here. Explosions. Escapes. Cigars.
It is locked. Allow me, Herr General.
So, you keep them locked up. It's a very interesting trait of character, Klink.
They are my little prisoners.
Excuse me, General, would you wish me to take all this down?
As you wish. Mainly, you just sit there and look pretty.
Thanks, I will.
Not you.
Sorry. Bum ba bum bum bum, rum ba bum bum bum, rum ba bum bum bum. Incredible!
Yes, sir, Commandant.
How well they play, these prisoners! Would you believe it? This is their first rehearsal.
They must be trained musicians, sir, Commandant.
They play Wagner like Germans. You know, Helga, you know that the whole of our beautiful national soul, our culture, is expressed in the ride of the Valkyries.
As a warrior, you must feel it deeply.
I do. Perhaps someday, as a fallen hero, I shall be carried off to Valhalla across the saddle of a beautiful German war maiden.
Such as you, my dear Helga.
Are you volunteering for active duty, Herr Commandant?
Be quiet and listen to the music.
Sign here, Colonel. And here. And here.
Without requisitions, there would be no war.
Like
it. Wie geht's, baby?
Hi, Annie. What's the general doing in there with Klink?
The only reason you kiss me is to get information from me.
Come on, honey, that's not true. There are other reasons. For openers, I'm a man, you're a woman. It's about all I remember from those training films. About the general.
The only thing I know is that he pinched me.
At least we know what he likes.
What if Commandant Klink catches us?
Prisoners are allowed 1 hour recreation a day. I miss the volleyball game.
You smell good.
The boys whipped up a little aftershave.
It's very exciting.
It's called unconditional surrender, honey.
May I ask what is going on here? She was blocking the door, sir.
Well, I told him that you were busy, Colonel.
Fräulein Helga is just doing her duty like any German soldier, a highly trained machine.
Must be tough getting spare parts for that machine, huh? You may go now.
Thank you, sir.
Ah, Fräulein Helga, take some dictation, please. Now, the first letter is going to Colonel Oscar Pfefferman, commanding officer of...
What's the matter, Fräulein Helga?
Colonel, somehow you look different today.
I do?
You look younger.
I do?
And the way you walk. You have such a youthful spring in your step.
You know something? I am beginning to feel a lot better today. What's the matter?
Sir, I think there's some dandruff.
Dandruff?
Have you been using some sort of hair tonic?
Hair tonic? No.
Come in.
Colonel Klink?
We will finish that letter later, Fräulein Helga.
Good afternoon, Colonel Hogan.
Nice to see you, Klink.
I won't let you in until you kiss me.
The things I have to do for my country.
Well, here we are again.
She keeps blocking the door. She's a regular tiger.
Well, he won't take no for an answer.
But what was the question?
I wanted to see you.
Fräulein Helga, you may go now and keep up the good work. Fräulein Helga, please fire these.
I told her you wanted to see me.
Well, he's always trying to break into your office.
The use of judo on a prisoner of war is against the Geneva Conference.
Fräulein Helga, you may let him go. Good work.
Thank you.
Colonel Hogan, come in.
I will finish dictating those reports later, Fräulein Helga.
Very good, Herr Colonel.
You look beautiful today, baby.
Charles!
Excuse me, Herr Colonel.
Yes, 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 what is it?
There are two officers here to see you, sir.
Who are these people? Is Starlock 13 a tourist attraction for every officer who passes through town? Soon we'll be serving tea.
They're from the Adolf Hitler division.
Well, don't just stand there. Make some tea.
Don't do that, Colonel Hogan. Leaves me weak.
Weak?
Very.
What's the Colonel want to see me about?
I can't tell you. I'm not supposed to tell you. No.
Honey, I've got all night.
What was the question?
Forget.
I have to see the big shots.
Well, he's on the phone, but he'll be out in a minute.
I can wait, baby.
Yes, and he's personally supervising the search for you-know-who.
That's a break for our side. They tell him I'm here.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'm coming down. Colonel Hogan is here.
Oh, doesn't he realize how busy I am? All right, send him in.
They let us roster, sir.
Thank you. Oh, please, let me help you, sir.
Hey, hey, what are you doing?
Please sit down. You look pale and drawn. I've seen it before.
Seen it? Seen what? What?
Please, please, very gallant of you to try to deny it, sir. You see it, don't you, Fräulein Helga?
What are you...
I do, I do.
What are you talking? Thank you.
Please, please.
Thank you.
I may be wrong, sir. May not be my place, but I've got to tell you. You look tired, very tired. Right, Fräulein Helga?
Oh, yes, the colonel is right, Herr Commandant.
Oh. And what do you think of it, Fräulein Helga?
I am speechless, Herr Commandant.
I can understand that. I am a man of many sides. You didn't know that behind that stern soldier there is a world traveler, a dreamer, a lover.
You are a dreamer.
That's my secret. And now it is yours too, oh, Fräulein Helga. You are my Lorelei. Soft nights, tropical breezes. Ich weiß nicht, was soll es bedeuten, dass ich so traurig bin.
Oh, I'm sorry.
What do you want, Colonel Hogan?
It can wait. It's not important. It's about the party tonight.
Oh, come in, come in.
This is the only way to fight the war, you know that.
Yeah, but... I wish that we would be on the same side.
I'll come over.
I only see you a few minutes at a time.
Helga, how would you like to go to a party tomorrow night?
Wunderbar. Oh, I love parties. But what is the occasion?
Hitler's birthday.
Oh. Well, maybe we'll have a good time anyway.
I was thinking, perhaps if you invited some of your girlfriends, some blondes, brunettes, redheads, a nice assortment, you know, I'd arrange to have you all picked up and taken over to Schmeckhausen.
Schmeckhausen? But there's nothing in Schmeckhausen.
We're arranging something right now.
And how will you get out of camp?
Don't go away.
Yes, come in.
Herr Kommandant, Colonel Hogan is here.
Send him in. We will complete our dossier later, Fräulein Helga.
Yes, sir.
How about the little smile, baby?
Try to attend to business.
He's trying, Colonel.
He can do that outside. Dismiss. Now, you cannot blame prisoners for not giving information.
I know a man is keeping secrets when he avoids looking directly at me. Even Fräulein Helga noticed it.
That's right, sir. The sergeant's eyes kept moving away from you and looking over at me.
You see?
And he didn't even look me in the eye. The colonel will be here in a moment.
Thanks, Helga.
He seems very angry with you. Have you done something naughty?
No, but I might as well.
Wait, Helga! No. You cannot have the afternoon off. That's what you were going to ask me, wasn't it?
No, I was just going to tell you that Colonel Hogan is here.
Oh. But you did want the afternoon off at some time, didn't you?
Yes, about 2 weeks ago.
I thought so. Don't try to keep any secrets from me. Now go and send in Colonel Hogan. Hogan, what happened?
I just told her a joke.
You did? I would like to hear it.
You wouldn't like it. Here he comes, you know what to do.
Hi, Carter.
Hi, Colonel Hogan.
Good day, Sergeant.
Hi, Fräulein Helga. Ma'am.
Working hard?
About the same as always.
We never get a chance to talk very much, do we? Seems there's always people around.
Yeah, well, it's a pretty crowded war.
Yes, a pity. We ought to get better acquainted.
Oh, sure. I wouldn't mind being friends, even if we are enemies.
Of course, if you are friends, we could do things together.
Like what?
Well, I don't know.
You want to help me empty the wastebasket?
Commandant in?
I'm sorry he's taking his nap.
Oh, I'll see him later. Now, hold it. Now, a little bit to the left.
What is it, Colonel Hogan?
You know, Helga, I never realized what perfect bone structure you have for photography.
I have? Perfect?
The best I've ever seen. You know, with your bone structure, you'd be a natural for movies. Ah, you've been told that 1,000 times.
No, never.
Oh, come on, you're kidding me. Hey, look, I've got a friend in Hollywood. If you got some pictures of yourself, I could send them to him. And after the war, who knows, you could be a big star.
Oh, I think I'd like that. But I don't have any photographs.
Oh, what a shame. I know he'd be crazy about your bone structure. Why don't you come outside? I'll take the pictures myself.
But the commandant?
He's asleep. He'll never know. Hey, look, have you got a bathing suit? Sometimes these producers like to see more than bones.
Ready?
Good girl. That's great. Another one. Good. Oh,
beautiful.